Hey guys, welcome back for another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez. You can find me on Twitter at JRFromPTC. In today's tutorial, I'll be showing you the highly requested technique that gives photos a trendy, gritty, high contrast and desaturated look. I don't actually know if this look has a name or not, but if you know what it is, feel free to leave it in the comments down below. Anyway, you've probably seen a similar grungy effect in movie posters and advertisements. I think Nike has used it a lot lately, or at least something similar. This effect is actually quite simple. All we'll use is two adjustment layers and one filter. One of those adjustment layers is the color lookup adjustment layer, which is new in Photoshop CS6. If you have CS5 or older, don't worry about it. I'll be showing you an alternative technique that should give you very similar results. If you would like to follow along this tutorial with the image that I'm using, you can download it for free. Look for the link down below. If you're a newsletter subscriber, you'll recognize this image. We've used it in the Halloween effects tutorial, where I showed you how to turn someone into a vampire and add digital bruises and scars. By the way, if you're not a newsletter subscriber yet and you enjoy my tutorials, sign up now. It's free. All you have to do is enter your email address in the box on the sidebar of my website, PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. But anyway, let's get started with this tutorial. The first thing I'm going to do is duplicate the background layer. So I'm going to press Control J, that's Command J on the Mac, and I'm going to add a black and white adjustment layer, and that's to desaturate the image. By the way, some people like to use a hue saturation adjustment layer and then bring the saturation slider all the way to the left to desaturate. That works okay, but I prefer the black and white adjustment layer, and I'll show you why. If I go into Window, History, and create a new snapshot. So this is snapshot number one that we just created. This is the original. And at this point, I can now delete the hue and saturation adjustment layer. I'm going to turn on the black and white adjustment layer. And at this point, they're pretty much the same. If I click on snapshot one and delete layer, which is the history state that we're at now, you really don't see a difference. There's a very subtle difference that you probably couldn't see through the video. But if I start making adjustments to the reds and the yellows, you can quickly see a difference. And I'm going to create a snapshot of the black and white adjustments I just made. So this is the desaturated image with the hue and saturation adjustment layer. And this is the snapshot with the black and white adjustment layer. So as you can see, it gives you a whole lot more flexibility. So that's what we're going to use. I'm just going to close that since we won't be using it anymore. And I'm going to bring the opacity down. So I'm going to put this somewhere around 75%. You might want to go lower or higher depending on your image. Don't try to match all the settings I give you because they're very specific to this image. They might work for your image, but I would recommend playing around with the settings and seeing what works better for your image. So for this image, I'm going to leave my opacity at 75%. Then I'm going to press Control E, Command E on the Mac, to merge down, which combines the adjustment layer and the layer onto one layer. Or you could also go to Layer, Merge Down. Then I'm going to duplicate this layer by pressing Control J, Command J on the Mac. And I'm going to go into Filter, Other, High Pass. And this is going to give me the high pass filter. The settings that you want to use here are all relative to your image. You're probably not going to go this high since you want to be somewhere around here where you can see the outline and some texture on the skin of your subject. You also don't want to go too low because then you really can't see any lines or texture. So you have to sort of find a nice medium. And for me, it'll be somewhere around 6.1. So I'm going to press OK. Then I'm going to go into the layer blending mode and select overlay. And as you can see, this already gave my image a much sharper look. I'm going to zoom in so you can see. So this is the what it looks like now, and this is before I added that high pass filter. So as you can see, it gives it a whole lot more contrast. I'm going to zoom out just so we can see the entire image, and I'll do the before and after here so you can see as well. Then I'm going to add a new color lookup adjustment layer, and I'm going to select teal orange plus contrast and just bring the opacity down. And that right there is just going to automatically color my image and give it a whole lot more character. So once again, I'm going to zoom in just so you can see the difference. And actually, I'm just going to put all these three layers that I've been working with in one group. So this is before, and that's after. Notice the dramatic change and how much better it looks just by adding a few simple layers and one filter. Now, if you're using an older version of Photoshop, Photoshop CS5 or older, you're not going to have the color lookup adjustment layer. So what you can do then is use another technique, and I'll show you what that is. So I'm just going to duplicate all the layers, including the background layer, and I'm going to add that to my group copy. And I'm going to delete the color lookup adjustment layer. So the group on the bottom contains the original group we were working with, and this group on top I'm going to use to show you what you can use in an older version of Photoshop. So I'm just going to click on the top layer, and I'm going to add a gradient map. I'm going to set the gradient map to soft light. I'm going to bring the opacity down just a little bit, maybe to 62% or so. And I'm going to change the colors. And the colors I'm going to use is a bluish color that I've predetermined. So that's 1F3946. And for the lighter color, I'm going to use E8CC7F and press OK. I'm going to move the swatch here over to the right a little bit, all the way to 25%, and then press OK. Now, when I shut off the visibility to the top group, you'll see that it's very similar to the one at the bottom. It's not an exact match, but it's pretty close. So if you have an older version of Photoshop, this is what you can do. And that's it for this tutorial, guys. This is officially the shortest tutorial that I've done, but I've got a lot of email requests on how to achieve this effect. So I figured I would just throw a quick tutorial up for you guys and show you how to easily create this. It doesn't take a lot of time at all. It could really improve your images just by simply adding a few adjustment layers and one filter. If you have any questions, please leave them down below. Also, if you create an image using this tutorial, feel free to share it on my Facebook page, send me a tweet, or you can also send me a message on Google+. And by the way, if you want to receive an email notification every time I put up a new tutorial, feel free to go to my website, photoshoptrainingchannel.com, and enter your email address in the sidebar to join my free newsletter. And I hope you learned something new. Once again, thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys again next time.